You made it.
Oh, please. It's a cute house. Has good curb appeal.
This house itself, 4-bedroom, 2-bath. It's a little bit over 1,700 square feet. So it's a good size house.
And they want 565.
Yeah. That was the first house I ever flipped. 4-bedroom, 2-bath, 1,900 square feet. It has a lot of characters, Cape Cod style, super cute. It has a huge yard. Made 84,000, sold it for 770.
Not bad.
My first flip was in 2005, which was around the same time that me and Christina met. When I made that quick cash, I got hit with the house flipping bug. Unfortunately, shortly after, the market crashed, and as a real estate agent, it was really tough. So a few years later, I started flipping distressed properties, and there's been no looking back.
So let's see what we find inside.
Open it up.
Well, it's dark.
Look at the carpet, it's like black, but it's supposed to be white.
Oh my God, look at the size of this fireplace.
Yeah, we've dealt with a fireplace like this before in a house. Cost a fortune to try to get rid of it.
Look at all these windows.
But it's just still so dark.
There are literally cracks everywhere. There's some weird stuff going on with the settling on this house. That's scary.
Let's go into the kitchen. This is really weird. They like built an oven into the fireplace.
This is a huge eyesore. Like completely blocks off the house.
These lower cabinets right here are also blocking out that window. And then plus the window with that little stain design thing is not helping the light situation.
That's fancy. All right, so you stand right here. It has the potential to have a good layout.
It has the potential to have a good layout once it's completely opened up.
You know what's really weird? Why would they separate this room?
Looks like an addition.
It definitely looks like an addition. I wonder if it's permitted.
This room as it stands is not good.
If this wall was gone, the whole corner of the house would be glass.
These are big sliders. Once upon a time, this was a really cute garden, like 30 years ago. All the cement's like buckling.
I don't know. There's something going on. Maybe that's why they're asking 565.
Too good to be true, probably is.
Well, he said as is and he wants us to move fast, so maybe there's something he knows that we don't.
Is Jeff coming out?
Yeah, he'll be here soon. So bathroom one. Good sized bathroom, actually. Easy gut, redo, 8,000, 9,000, not too bad. Ooh, someone's sleeping in here for sure.
The carpet is really gross. It looks like mold.
That's just the wallpaper.
Yeah, listen to that. Ew. Bedroom number two looks just the same in decor as bedroom number one.
Uh-oh, we're sloping.
Wanna peel back the carpet and take a look?
Go ahead.
No, I don't touch carpet. This is a master?
I mean, it's decent size. I mean, for a 1,700 square foot house, what really counts is the bathroom. Let's see this thing.
Very 50s. Where's the shower?
It's right here. You know what?
We might
be able to expand it. Let me see what's on the other side. So the shower itself would be right here behind that. You know what? Yeah, check it out. We can easily double the size of that shower.
Perfect.
Probably about 10,000 in there. This bedroom is probably the smallest.
This is like the only room in the entire house that has light.
565, huh?
Yeah, what's wrong?
Jeff will be here soon. He should know.
I got confirmation from the seller that the back part of the house is permitted, and I bought the house for $565,000. The biggest challenge that we have right now is the layout. But until Jeff gets the structural engineer out here, there is no way to know the cost. Fingers crossed.
Throw this thing in here.
Yeah, buddy.
A little bit of adhesive down.
Watch your fingers.
You're on there? Man, this island looks killer. Once we get the backsplash in with that really cool 3D design, it's gonna be awesome in here. I think this house is gonna sell fast.
Looks like a good house.
Hi.
Hey, I got a question. Don't those look kind of green, like the color of your shirt?
It's gonna look better once all the tiles are up and the walls are painted.
No, I actually kind of like it. I like how it plays off the floor.
It has a cool, like, rustic, modern vibe.
What do you think about that backsplash?
It's actually a little more simple than I thought it would be, but it looks good. Oh, painting, are we?
Oh, yeah. I picked some pretty cool colors.
What's that orange I see?
I was thinking we're gonna do body of the house gray, white trim. Front door, orange, yeah, I know you. Or just keep it simple and we stick with the black.
I like the orange.
The orange might work. It's kind of cool, kind of different.
What else are we doing out here? It's looking a little sparse.
Pretty much wherever you see bare areas, we can add mulch and flowers and some plants.
Okay.
House gray, white trim, orange door. Done.
Game plan.
This house looks way better.
It has a rustic feel now, especially with the front door color.
Hi, how's it going?
Hi, how are you?
Good. How you doing?
I'm John Cohout. I'm getting ready to list the house across the street and was hoping that I could find out some information about what you guys have going on.
Which one across the street?
It's two stories.
The one literally two doors down to the right?
Yeah, with the two dormers.
We just gotta make sure we don't list it at the same price.
That flip is definitely haunting you. First we show up and it's like right across the street and now it's coming back on the market?
Well, clearly he came over because he knows we remodeled the house and he's dying to know what we're gonna list the house for.
Right, aren't you dying to know what he's listing it for?
Yes, because if we come in way too high and they come in lower, we're gonna look really bad and we're gonna sit on the market and not sell.
So what were you guys planning on listing the house for?
Somewhere north of 750. What about you?
Well, good question.
When are you guys listing?
Within the next week. How about you?
All right, well, we're gonna be coming on the market in the next few days.
Okay.
Once I see the sign in the yard, I'll give you a call, figure out where you're listing at.
Absolutely.
So nice to meet you.
You too.
Nice meeting
you.
Thank you. Good luck.
All right, so the numbers on the house. We paid $565,000. So with the rehab and the staging, we spent about $93,000. Our break even is going to be $688,000. All the comps I'm finding are up the hill and it sells for more that way, and those are selling in the high sevens.
So what do you want to list this place for?
That house is better than this house. He thinks upper sevens. So for sure, I say we don't go above eight.
What do you want to do?
I think $799,900.
Oh my gosh, you just said that house is nicer. Now he's going to come on the market lower than us.
I'm going $799,900.
All right. You're the boss.
Hey.
When I was pulling up, I saw that the neighbor has a for sale sign. Tell me, they listed higher than us.
They listed at $765,000.
And we're at $799,000.
Yeah.
It's crazy.
I'm seriously thinking about dropping the price right now.
Well, let's see how today goes and, oh my gosh.
Well, hopefully it looks beautiful. I'll tell you what, that fireplace was the worst thing in this house.
It blocked the entire view. It looks so much better.
I mean, the space is amazing.
The two-tone cabinets look perfect. Love them, love the backsplash. It's really pretty.
You know what I love about the backsplash is like the three-dimensional look, it really pops.
I like how there's an eat-in kitchen area over here, formal dining room, all the beautiful windows.
Oh, did I tell you that I had him redo the concrete?
Oh. It actually looks cute out here. Great decision. And most importantly, I love the herbs. Beautiful, beautiful. I love how they staged it with all these plants. Bathroom looks nice.
I love the coloring.
Everything looks very big. It looks very contemporary. All right, the master.
The closets are huge.
This room looks really nice and beautiful view.
I love this.
The design looks amazing.
It really did come together.
Removing that closet was definitely the right decision.
I am probably 95% sure we're gonna have to reduce the price.
Well, let's sit up and see what people have to say.
This is beautiful.
I like that blue-gray color.
Oh my gosh.
Wow, this is beautiful.
I like the color of the floors, especially like the white. I don't see it that often.
And look at this countertop and the tile. Kind of simple, but pizzazzy.
Wonderful area out here. Maybe we can put a fire pit.
Could plan a lot of good stuff back here.
The open house went great, but to be competitive with my old flip, I had to drop the price. And I ultimately sold the house for $770,000. After closing costs and commission, if this deal goes through, we stand to make a profit of almost $80,000.